Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel and I hope you are doing amazing. Happy Monday. So what's the topic today? The topic is let go to create space for new things. Well, yesterday, me, my husband and our son, we were all cleaning up. We had a room in our house which was full of kids stuff, like it included stuff from the day when my son was born, starting from that trolley and every other thing. And this room was like more like a storeroom, not more like a room to play for the kids, but it was more like a storeroom. And we have been planning to do this, to let go his toys and make space for the new ones, or rather just let go, some of the toys so that other children who are in need can play and enjoy. But making that decision was very hard because sometimes I would be emotional about it, sometimes my husband, sometimes my son, and of course he wouldn't want single toy of his to let go. So every other day we found that it was very, very difficult to kind of let it go because we attached an emotion to it. And then I realized that, why it is difficult to let go and why it is important to let go. Because if we have to create space for something new, we have to let go. And it is very important as human beings to kind of do a scrutiny of what are we holding back and what do we need to let go so that we create space for something new, something good, and then that will help us to evolve to our next level. So that's the reason why I'm making this video. So why it is hard to let go? It is hard to let go because we have an emotional attachment to it. We have a story connected to that, and that makes us difficult. We cannot destroy the energy or we cannot create the energy, but we can transform it or transfer it. And when a child makes something, he is making it with a lot of emotions, and there is a emotion involved to it, and then as parent we get so attached to it. So giving this as an example, you can really look at things which you find it let go. It could be your habits, it could be your ways of doing things, it could be the organization that you're working with, it could be even a relationship that you know is not working and it's not serving you, but you're finding it difficult to let go because you have an interpretation, a story, a kind of story in your mind that is playing, and so it's becoming very, very difficult. So what if you kind of get curious about the story and the interpretation that you're holding and ask yourself, is it worth it? Is it serving me? And you know what? Unless and until we let go, we cannot create new things. We cannot create space for new things. And this toy room was a very, very simple yet striking example, which reminded me of many things, which I found to let go. The other day, my coach was asking me, challenging me to kind of adopt a different coaching style in my coaching sessions and do something which I avoided doing. Why do we get into this coaching engagement? To develop ourselves to our next potential. And if I have to create something new, then that means I have to also make room for something new by letting go something which I have become very comfortable with, or which I have become very, very super duper cool with that. And that has got me some results, definitely. But there is something called neuroplasticity, which is the more you challenge your mind to do newer things, newer ways, your learning and the horizon will broaden. You will expand as a person. You will always gain. We fear, right, that if I let go of this, then what if, like, I don't remember? But think of it, like, once you know driving, if you now try something else, you're not going to forget driving. The moment you hold the steering, you will just start and go for it. So what I'm trying to say is that, so when my coach said that, you know, do it, try, first of all, be observant of what are the things that you avoid doing it, and then see for the things that you have been doing it, and now do the things which you avoid. That will help you to increase your muscle of expansion, you know, as a having a wider perspective, challenging yourself so that you don't settle for something comfortable and less, but always try for something which is which will be very, very empowering, and that will take you to the next level, and that is going to create space for even having a different set of clients, or even having a different kind of you know, experience of life and in the coaching space as well. So my first reaction was, what if I forget? I'm good at this. I'm good at doing this. What if I then not be that and become something, and, you know, become somebody I'm not? And that is the thing. That's the courage we need, to be willing to rupture and disrupt and kind of sit in that discomfort. Because once you try out new things, you have to break down what you have been doing it, and it requires courage to be able to do that. Letting go requires courage. Letting go requires you to see the big picture. Letting go requires you to have that discipline and commitment and an intention to create space for the new, because you know that where you are, it is not the end. And to grow, you can't stagnate. You have to move to the next thing. And one thing that has always helped me is the interpretation that I have been holding on to, just like the toy room. So, well, my invitation to you from this video, the reflection point or the food of thought, would be, what are the things that you know you would like to let go but still cling on to it? And what is the reason for that? And ask yourself, how would life be when you let go of that and embrace something new year? Open the new ways of doing things. Open to creating space for something new. And unless and until you do that, nothing new is going to come to your life. And I think, since we are almost towards the end of this year 2020, what good a time would be to do a reflection of that entire year 2020. Well, that's it I have for today in this video. Don't forget to like, share, and those who are new to my channel, please subscribe. And if you like what I do, then please do share my video and help me grow so that I can be more inspired to make more videos and contribute. And if you would like to get on coaching engagement with me, do write to me at priyanka@priyankadatta.com. You'll find links here. And yeah, looking forward. Until next, take care, love you all, bye-bye.